गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. टूडे वी विल डिस्कस द आंसर्स ऑफ आर सब्जेक्टिव एग्जाम्स दैट वर कंडक्टेड. ओके, सो टूडे वॉट इज द डेट? टूडे टूडे इज 13th of August. ओके, एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आर सब्जेक्टिव पेपर. नाउ बेटा, सेक्शन ए, इन सेक्शन ए द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वॉज राइट द मीनिंग ऑफ. यस, सो फर्स्ट वर्ड वॉज मिरेकल. What is the meaning of miracle? Magic. Then second word was overwhelmed. What is the meaning of overwhelmed? Feeling of being too happy. Now what was the third word? Spectacle. What is the meaning of spectacle? Meaning of spectacle is sight. Then last one, clasped. What is the meaning of clasped? Meaning of clasped is hugged. Okay, so these are the answers written here. Magic. B is feeling of being too happy, C is sight, and D is hugged. Okay, now we will move to question number 2. In question number 2, it is read the extract and answer the following questions. What is the extract? But as she was about to keep the chapati on the window's sill as usual, her hands trembled. What is this I am doing? At once, she threw the chapati into the fire, prepared another one and kept it on the window's sill. The hunchback came, picked up the chapati and muttered the words, "The evil you do remains with you, the good you do comes back to you." From which story is this taken? From which story is this taken? It is taken from the story, the extra chapati. It is taken from the story. It is taken from the story, the extra chapati. Okay, the extra chapati. Now next question, what is this I am doing? What is the lady referring to this sentence? Lady is referring to the poison that she was going to add in the chapati. Lady is referring to the poison she was going to add in the chapati. She was going to add poison in the chapati, na? So that is only she was referring to. Okay, she is referring to the poison she was going to add in the chapati. Now next is, what is the meaning of hunchback in the above story? The hunchback meaning is what is the meaning of hunchback? Hunchback means a person who has hump on his back, jiske piche pe hump hota hai. Okay, on his back is known as hunchback. Okay, what is the moral of the story? The moral of the story is ki whatever you do come back to you. It's given on the last line. The last line is D. Good. Good you do. Acha, good you do. Good you do comes back to you. Good you do will be done to you. Good you do will be done to you. And evil begets you. Okay, so this is the moral of this story. Got it? So these are the answers of second part, question number 2, part A, B, C and D. Now let's move to the third one. Okay, now let's move to the third question. The third question was, read the extract and answer the following questions. And the penguin strutting around the lake can understand the remarks you make. From which poem is the above extract taken? From which poem is it taken? It is taken from the poem Zoo Manners. It is taken from the poem Zoo manners. Name the poet. Who is the poet? Poet is Elen Mathias. Elen Mathias. Okay. So let's see. Okay. Third part A. The poem is, name of the poem is Zoo Manners. Who has written that poem? Elen Mathias. Yes. Now let's see the C part. Why should we not make fun of camel's hump? Why should we not make of camel's hump? Because it is very proud of its hump. Because it is very proud of it. So we should not make the fun of it. Okay. Now D part. Pick out the rhyming words from the extract. See, you can write. Now D part. What is the rhyming word in the extract? The rhyming word is lake and make. Okay. So this is the rhyming word. Got it? Now let's come to the fourth part. Answer the following questions, any two. How can you say house sparrows are social beings? We can say house sparrows are social beings because they never harm human beings. वो कभी भी human beings को harm नहीं करती हैं और हमारे habitat में हमारे साथ रहती हैं. Okay, next one. What was merchant's dilemma? Merchant's dilemma was that whom should he hand over his property so that he or she can take care of the property till his son comes back from the job. From the studies. Now, what did the uninvited guest bring to Fox's wedding? The uninvited guest brought nothing to the Fox's wedding. ओके अनइनवाइटेड गेस्ट फॉक्स की वेडिंग के लिए कुछ भी नहीं लाया. नथिंग टू द फॉक्सेस वेडिंग. गॉट इट? ओके चिल्ड्रेन, नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट ग्रामर पार्ट. वी ऑलवेज ट्रैवल बाय एयर इंडिया. यू हैव टू अंडरलाइन प्रॉपर नाउन हेयर. प्रॉपर नाउन इज द प्रॉपर नेम दैट इज गिवेन टू अ पर्सन, प्लेस, एनिमल और थिंग. सो हेयर व्हाट इज द प्रॉपर नेम? प्रॉपर नेम इज एयर इंडिया. व्हाई? बिकॉज एयर इंडिया इज नेम ऑफ अ कंपनी. ओके, सो इट इज एयर इंडिया. नाउ सी द नेक्स्ट वन. द बेबी क्राइड इन पेन. Pain. See, what is the abstract noun? Abstract noun is name of the feeling. So what is the feeling here? The feeling here is pain. So you will underline pain. Okay. Now next, a flock of sheep was grazing in the field. Underline the collective noun. What is the collective noun here? That is telling the collection, flock. What is the collective noun here? Collective noun is flock. So you will underline flock. Okay. Now next, the house of Mr. Biswas. Use apostrophe and rewrite the sentence. So you can write Mr. Biswas. Biswas. And then you will write apostrophe. Mr. Biswas house. Got it? Okay, I can see that mango tree. What is that? That here is adjective. And which type of adjective? It is demonstrative adjective. Okay, because it is demonstrating something. Demonstrative adjective. Okay, now I myself solved the sum. I myself solved the sum. Myself is the pronoun here and it is emphatic pronoun. Why is it emphatic pronoun? मैम ने आपको बताया था कि अगर दोनों एकदम बगल बगल लो, pronoun and sorry, the pronoun about what you are talking or the noun about what you are talking and the pronoun with self in it. If it is next to each other, then it is emphatic. And if one is in the subject and other is in the object, then it is reflexive. Okay. Now next, write the verbs and write whether they are transitive or intransitive. I worked all night. Is there any object in this sentence? No.
what you worked all night. It is not the correct answer. So it is intransitive verb. Okay, it is intransitive verb. Now, he gave the book to the teacher. What he gave? Book. तो इसमें आपको करेक्ट आंसर मिल रहा है. सो इट इज ट्रांसिटिव. ही लाफ्ड एट द जोक. ऑन वॉट ही लाफ्ड? वॉट ही लाफ्ड ऑन? जोक. सो हेयर ऑल्सो यू हैव गॉट द ऑब्जेक्ट. सो इट इज ट्रांसिटिव. नाउ नेक्स्ट, वी लिव्ड इन मेक्सिको फॉर 2 years. वॉट यू लिव्ड? यू आर नॉट गेटिंग द आंसर, है ना? सो इट विल बी इन transitive. Okay, so it will be in transitive. Now let's see the next one. Insert the article. My mother is an English teacher. I am a student. When I get home from the school, I watch the programs. I watch C part is the. Okay, for C you will write the. I watch the programs on the TV. That's the best. That's the best part of my day. The programs I watch are for children. Here no article will be there. Okay. Now last one, fill up the blanks with appropriate collective nouns. A dash of wolves, a pack of wolves. A dash of dancers, a troop of dancers. Okay? So these are the answers of subjective type questions of your English. Okay?